everybody. Yesterday, we had 48,000 people come forward and get tested, which means the numbers are holding high in terms of the rates of testing. We desperately need that to continue to make sure we're capturing all the cases of community transmission out there. To 8pm last night, we had 112 additional cases. And I want to stress the vast majority of these cases are family members or very, very close contacts. So family or close friends, unfortunately, bear the brunt of those 112 numbers that we've seen overnight. And that's why I want to stress again, as we did yesterday, if you put yourself at risk, you're putting your entire family, and that means extended family, as well as your closest friends and associates at risk, and the numbers are telling in that regard. In terms of the number of people that were exposed in the community whilst they're infectious, there are at least 34, and that is the number that we need to see as close to zero as possible before health will advise the government that the lockdown can end. So can I stress that is the number that we need to see go down to as close to zero as possible before we can get advice from health to say the lockdown can end. And it's critical. That's something all of us have a role to play in. All of us have to make sure that if anyone has symptoms, get tested and stay at home. Don't go to work. And under no circumstances should anybody be visiting another household. And certainly, more strongly, we want to stress that the virus is still concentrating in two or three local government areas. And as we did for the Northern Beaches, when we singled out those suburbs and local government areas where the virus was rampant, the virus, the vast majority of cases are still in the Fairfield local government area, and I need to call that out. Everybody in Fairfield should be staying at home unless they absolutely have to. Now, that is the message across everywhere in Greater Sydney, but in particular, when large numbers of the virus are circulating in one local government area, we must call that out so that people are aware and people can keep themselves safe and their family safe. We're also seeing, of course, a considerable amount of cases in the Canterbury-Bankstown local government area and the Liverpool Council local government area. They're the three main local government areas where the majority of cases are. But the vast majority of those cases are in the Fairfield local government area. And Dr. Chant will read out the specific suburbs. We need to call that out because that's where the virus is spreading the most. And we really want to stress that even if you regard yourself as an essential worker, especially in the Fairfield local government area, do not leave home if you have symptoms. Do not go to work unless you absolutely know that you don't have the virus. Because unfortunately, we're seeing very, very key workers, unfortunately, leave the home with symptoms or else not knowingly spreading the virus. So if you're a key worker or you work in multiple sites and you're from the Fairfield local government area, we would prefer you stayed at home unless you absolutely had to leave the house and unless you can assure that you're a negative COVID test before you proceed to your normal activities. And that is really, really important for us to stress. Again, it's up to all of us to see that number of exposures in the community go down. If you have the mildest of symptoms, get tested, stay home until health advises you otherwise. Please also do not go to your medical centre, a pharmacist or a GP if you have symptoms, because we're seeing people unfortunately turn up to waiting rooms of medical centres or GP clinics or else going into pharmacies when they've got symptoms and unintentionally passing the virus on to other people in the waiting area or their GPs or pharmacists. And we need to make sure that if you have symptoms, your first stop should be to the COVID test and stay home until you get the results and you get the health advice. If you have symptoms and you need medical attention, please call and that medical attention will arrive. But we don't want to run the risk of people having symptoms, going to a workplace or going to a medical centre and spreading the virus. And that's really, really important for us to stress. So just to summarise, the three key areas we want people to focus on today and moving forward is, one, it's a fact that if you get the virus, the next people who'll get it will be those you love the most. That is a fact. Number two, too many essential workers doing essential work for all of us are leaving work with symptoms or unfortunately spreading the virus in their workplace, and that needs to stop. Do not leave your home if you have symptoms, and do not go to workplace, especially if you come from those local government areas that I've mentioned, if you suspect for even at 1% that you might have COVID, you have to go and get tested and stay home until you get the result. and that is really, really important. And obviously avoid GP clinics or medical centres or pharmacists if you feel you might have the disease. Do not go into those areas because unfortunately we're seeing medical practice, medical practices have that happen to them. I also wanted to stress the New South Wales government has done some great work in the last few days in relation to the vaccine rollout. So from now, we'll be able to accept anybody over 40 who wants the AstraZeneca. As you know, the federal health advice or the regulatory advice is that over 60s can get AstraZeneca without any of those risk profiles that were identified. But if you're between 40 and 60 and want to get the AstraZeneca, you can go through the appropriate consent forms at all New South Wales health sites, which is very positive. But also we've had some outstanding conversations with the New South Wales Pharmacy Guild, and we're in the process of also allowing pharmacists across the state to provide AstraZeneca to anybody over 40. So please consider your own risk, please consider your own health situation, but know that you can get the AstraZeneca if you're over 40 in any of our pharmacies, well, soon, in any of our pharmacies across the state. We're in the process of making that happen, but certainly you can start making bookings through New South Wales Health mass vaccination hubs if you want the AstraZeneca over 40. And can I stress that in the coming weeks, some commencing next week, we will have mass vaccination hubs across many areas, as we've said, the Hunter, Wollongong, Macquarie Fields, and also Fairfield Showground. So we are expanding the ability for people to access the vaccine. And of course, the more doses we get, the more doses we'll get out the door. I'm pleased to say the New South Wales health capacity on its own is 200,000 jabs a week. And that's not considering the GP network, who we understand can do about as much as well. So we've increased our capacity, we've increased our access, and now all we need are those extra doses. And every time we get those extra doses, we'll make sure that they get into arms, which is so critical and so important. I want to stress again, we are in an absolutely critical phase of this disease. All of us want to get out of this lockdown as soon as we can. All of us want to reduce the stress we're all feeling. And we are, the future is in our hands. It's up to us to make sure we get the word out. And whilst those three local government areas are where the most of the cases are certainly circulating, please know the risk is everywhere in those areas that we've asked for people to stay home. So the risk is everywhere, but we have to be upfront with where the virus is circulating at the moment, where people in those suburbs and those communities take extra care. And I know that the response in the last few days in particular has been quite distinctive insofar as we've seen a massive reduction in mobility. We've seen increase in people doing the right thing. And as Commissioner Fuller, who I'm pleased is with us today, will also reinforce, today being the 12th of July, there's mandatory QR codes for a number of venues which didn't require them before. And police will be making sure that businesses and individuals are doing the right thing in that regard. But please know, we don't want crowding anywhere. So if you're waiting to check in somewhere, make sure you're socially distancing, you're wearing a mask. The last thing we want is people giving the virus to each other if they're waiting around to check in or what have you. Make sure you think about those things. But again, overwhelmingly, we just want people to stay at home. The virus won't spread if people don't leave home. That's the bottom line. Don't leave home unless you absolutely have to. We know where the risks are. We know how the virus is spreading, and we just need people to follow the information we're providing. Thank you. Dr. Chant.
Thank you, Premier. So there were 112 locally acquired cases of COVID in the 24 hours to 8 p.m. last night and 46,478 tests. It's pleasing to see those test numbers remain high, but we have got more capacity. So we're suggesting and recommending a lot more testing, particularly in the areas of concern, so we can flush out any unrecognised cases and block those chains of transmission. Of the vast majority of cases are occurring in southwestern Sydney, southeastern Sydney, and we are seeing a small number of cases in western Sydney and Nepean Blue Mountains. I'm going to read out the key suburbs that where we have cases, and it is important. The reason I'm reading these locations is out is because we do need to make sure that every member of that community understands every time they go out of their house for an essential good, if they go shopping, they need to assume that someone next to them has COVID. Now, everyone across Greater Sydney should assume that. but we are conveying that in these areas, the risk is even greater. So when you are out and about for those very essential things that you need, please limit the time, go directly there, and make sure you're maintaining your social distancing, your mask is over your nose and mouth, and that you keep your social distance. The suburbs are Fairfield, Smithfield, Bosley Park, Fairfield Heights, Fairfield West, Wakeley, Bonnyrigg, Glenfield and West Hoxton. Also, I just want to highlight that we are also seeing cases emerge among young adults in the 18 to 20 year old age group in the Georges River, Bayside and Sutherland local government areas. And they're largely spreading it again, to echo the Premier's words, to their closest friends and family. So it's crucial that young adults also limit their social interactions at this time and also come forward for testing. In terms of New South Wales Health is also working with residents of an apartment block in the eastern suburbs where we have 8 cases of COVID, and they've been identified in recent days across 5 households in a block of 29 units. We've now identified the source and we'll be working with all residents to ensure we can safely move and provide care for those with COVID in a special health accommodation and support the needs of all other residents who are close contacts and must remain in quarantine in their homes for 14 days. I just want to express my gratitude to the residents of the department block for working so well with us during a very difficult time. But this is a reminder of the risks that COVID poses and why we were requiring masks and have been in indoor common property areas of residential premises, and also discourage social gatherings or any gatherings across household groups in those apartment buildings as well. Just to highlight that, even if you're going to get your waste disposal, other points of contact, please see that as a risk as well. And please make sure that you've got your mask affixed and you keep that social distancing. In terms of the impact of COVID, let me say that we will be collating the information and putting it in our epidemiology report in terms of the underlying health conditions of people that are hospitalised. But I can say that you don't need to have an underlying health condition to be in hospital with COVID. COVID is a serious disease and is associated with hospitalisation in death. Obviously, the risk increases with age and for those underlying health conditions. We currently have 63 COVID patients admitted to hospital. We've got 18 people in ICU, 4 of whom are ventilated. 25 people admitted to hospital at the moment are under the age of 55, and 14 are under the age of 35. Of the people in ICU, we have 1 in their 20s, 1 in their 30s, 1 in their 40s, 5 in their 50s, 6 in their 60s, 3 in their 70s, and 1 in their 80s. Again, dispelling the notion that you are not going to get sick from COVID if you're young. But I think the most important message, because no one wants to pass on COVID, no one wants to infect their loved ones. So please stay isolated, get tested if you have the most minimal symptoms. Just to reiterate the Premier's comments, what we are requiring is that everywhere is subject to the stay-at-home provisions. But we're highlighting the increased risk in those areas. So it's Fairfield local government area, some parts of Liverpool local government area, extending into Canterbury, Bankstown local government areas. And obviously I've mentioned those other areas of southeastern Sydney that we're also concerned about. If you need to leave home, it has to be absolutely essential if you live in particularly the Fairfield local government area. Do not visit any other households. And if you're a worker, stay at home unless you absolutely need to attend work. So essential aged care, emergency services, healthcare, other things that are critically essential. If you need to attend work, get tested before you go to work. And you don't need to isolate But if you can delay going to work until you've got a negative test, that's much preferred. But if you have the most minimal of symptoms, you have to stay isolated until you've got a negative test. If you're sick, please call ahead. Do not go to your general practitioner with respiratory illnesses. Please call ahead and ask about what the care path is best for you. We want to protect our healthcare services and other patients in those healthcare services that are obviously amongst our most vulnerable. Also, if you're going to pick up a script from a pharmacy, or you're going to get Panadol or other pain relief and you've got COVID symptoms, don't do that. Get a test, stay isolated, and ask one of your other household members without symptoms to go in, but go directly into the pharmacy, pick up the medication you require and go home. We don't want to see any other opportunities for COVID to spread in healthcare settings. In regard to the vaccine message, please go and get vaccinated. Please contact your general practitioner. See if you can have bookings for the AstraZeneca vaccine and in some cases Pfizer vaccine, which is available through general practice as well as through New South Wales Health. If you've had the AstraZeneca vaccine within the last 4 weeks, we're asking that you ring your GP and they may be able to bring forward your booking to that 6 to 8 week period. Now, clearly having the vaccine within the 6 to 8 weeks trades off the duration of protection that that vaccine might provide you. But we know that into the future, we will be providing booster doses of various vaccines. And what we want to do is protect you. But my other message is, even one dose of vaccine is worthwhile in improving your likelihood of hospitalisation. So please, even though the two doses is much more effective, even going forward and booking your first dose. We do want you to be patient to general practice, and general practice will try and meet those booking requirements, but we know that they will be prioritising the elderly as they work through. So if you are younger, please be a little patient with your general practitioner, but I would urge everyone to take up every opportunity to get vaccinated at this time.
Okay, that was an update there from Gladys Berejiklian and Kerry Chant, just to go over those numbers. 112 new cases and 34 were infectious in the community. Most of those, again, are family and close friends of a positive case. And another thing, 63 people in hospital, so that number's gone up. 18 in ICU, 4 ventilated. And one other thing I thought was interesting, people, when they have symptoms, are going to their GP and sitting in the waiting room and passing it on to other people, but you just cannot do that. It's if you've got symptoms, you have to get a test.
And call ahead and figure out what your best plan is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thanks, Nat.
All right, guys, we'll have all the details at 11:30.
We'll see you then.
Thanks, Nat. We'll